You close our top of 8 months. 8 months. Yes. I have a children, I have family, and I have been suffering since then to today. And you are telling me you haven't able to carry the media. If you tell me you are a media man, say the truth. Let the whole country know that what your people are doing is not good.
They make the market so polluted. That's what I mean. But they produce fast. They produce fast. So,
okay, welcome to my channel once again. Please. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so and subscribe to my channel. You don't lose anything by liking the video. So please and please again, just like the video. There is something that I have seen that it's actually a news portal. I think TV360 in Nigeria. I saw that news and it got me wondering that Africans, do we love ourselves enough? It's like every day we keep on blaming the colonists and what they did to us and everything. But Africans, truly, truly, do we love ourselves? Because there is some series of videos that I want to show you. Eh? There are some series of videos that I want to show you. And when you look at these videos, it's sad. I don't know why we keep doing this thing to these things to ourselves. There was a time that I was talking about in a video on my channel. I was talking about how Ghanaians treat Nigerian traders in Ghana, and I'm Ghanaian, but I was not really really happy. Although those people were saying it's actually in the law that no other nationality will come to Ghana or should come to Ghana and do retail business. Yes, so that's what they were saying. But to me, honestly, I was not in support of that.
Guta hate us and the government is pretending because of the election. It is not good. We are human beings. Okay? We are human beings. We are Africans. We are Nigerians. Even if you hate us, allow us to operate. You can't close our shop and telling us to keep quiet. And I know very well that all of you are going to edit it and use the one you like. Because most of you people are not in our favor. You are not telling the truth. Ghanaian citizens don't know. Ghanaian citizens don't know what we are passing through. Let the Ghanaian citizens know what we are passing through. It is not about us. Your people are manipulating. They are pretending. They are pretending. They are not saying the truth. We are so...
Fast forward. Just recently, I was watching a news from a Nigerian TV station and I saw Ghanaians who are also in Nigeria working and they are also being denied of also selling, like retailing basically. So they have just kept them at a particular place that if they need some of the items, they go to them, they buy it from them so that they can sell it to the public. And
this is Monkey Village, right here in Mende, Maryland, Lagos, Nigeria. In what appears to be the outback of the area, Ghanaian cane weavers are not allowed to venture beyond these parameters. While Nigerians are allowed to display their products, Ghanaians serve as laborers who manufacture these cane products for a fixed price.
54-year-old Adeyemi Bolarinwa concentrates hard as he weaves his basket. His colored hands work deftly, and in a matter of minutes, he finishes one of his orders. Bolarinwa's father is Nigerian, but his mother is Ghanaian. Despite his being a Nigerian, Bolarinwa cannot sell his products directly to buyers. He can only sell to a group of Nigerian cane weavers, who in turn sell directly to customers. It's a rule among the Cane Weavers Association here which restricts non-Nigerian cane weavers from dealing directly with customers.
They brought some job for one Niger man, according to the history, from 1986. Then the man delayed the job, and they saw another Ghanaian man. They went to, that's a Sheraton hotel. So they went to the guy, Ghanaian man, the Ghanaian man did the thing in time as they want. So the contract go to that Ghana man. So then, now those people are the indigenous, work against foreigners that they can share a place together. So the moment they granted that law still will work from 86 up to by this time. So Ghanaians don't have any choice to sell, to meet customer that or something like sell anything direct. So always we are in backyard that when they receive the order, they come and give us a job. That's the situation where we are facing now.
Why do Africans hate each other like that? Like, I don't understand. Why? What is the problem? Like, a Ghanaian selling in Nigeria, a Nigerian selling in Ghana, a South African selling in, let's say, Zambia. It's so beautiful. A Kenyan selling in Tanzania, a Congolese like selling in Ethiopia or something. It's so beautiful. Why do we keep doing these things to ourselves? I was really surprised because I never ever knew something of that sort was also going on in Nigeria against Ghanaians.
Kwaku Noah is another Ghanaian cane weaver in Maryland. For 15 years, Kwaku has struggled to make ends meet due to the trade inequality he suffers.
Maybe the price we are sell for woman as this back here. If I did roadside, one day, God go see me about a better customer where I can sell for the person where I go see game pass where I did. So it affects us. So if we are on the roadside, I'm sure say we go see better customer pass, better price pass, what we are gaining as the back here.
And one funny thing is one of the like the leaders in the Nigerian trade, that particular trade, I think it's weaving. They actually into artifact or craft or whatever. I don't even know how to even put it. That's what they are into. And one of them, one funny thing that he said was like, like Ghanaians over there, when they allow them, they sell their stuffs very cheap. And they are very fast in weaving the thing.
To confirm these allegations and to understand the root cause of the act of discrimination against the Ghanaian cane weavers in Maryland area of Lagos, I paid a visit to the chairman of the Cane Weavers Association in Maryland, Dennis Omadide. Surprisingly, Omadide confirms everything we've heard from the Ghanaian cane weavers. He explains that the Ghanaians are restricted for two major reasons. They work fast and they charge less. These two factors, he says, could disrupt the profit margins of Nigerian artisans.
To make the market so polluted, that's what I mean. They produce fast. They produce fast. So by the time you try to draw a kind of item that will come to market, it's like this. Then when they overflow, then the market, that market will not depreciate on that area. The reason why we do that, they are trying to frustrate the market in terms of sales in the beginning. So that's why we notice that instead of that to happen, let us stay on their own, then we should stay on our own.
And in Ghana too, when you ask the Ghanaian traders, they will tell you Nigerians too here, they sell their stuffs very cheap. So this thing got me laughing and I'm like, why are we doing this? Like, it's funny, eh? Very, very, very funny. But this is something serious. Like, just take a look at the previous video when Nigerian traders were angry and were just saying all sorts of things to the Ghanaian authorities and all that when they were locking their shops.
We are ECOWAS. Let's not focus about the ECOWAS issue. Think about human being. You will tell me that black life matters. When you have closed our shop for 8 good months, you know how many Nigerians that have died because of this.
And just look at same thing. Some Nigerians too in Nigeria also doing the same thing to Ghanaians. Why are we doing this to ourselves? We are all one people. We should stop this thing, Charlie. We should stop this thing. We should just put a stop to it. Let's all trade amongst ourselves. And the funny thing is, all of us are even in this West African region. So what are we doing to ourselves? Meaning this free African trade or whatever, or West African trade, or I've even forgotten the name. We are not agreeing to it. We should stop this. Thank you so much for watching.